Hello, and welcome to KDAB News, the monthly update for professionals working with Qt, C++, and 3D technologies. I'm Robert Brock, and for this special edition from QtDevCon, we have interviews with Maurice Kalinowski, Anne Rueß, Dario Freddi, and a blog from Ecolabs, and our announcements. Hello, Maurice. It's nice to see you in person.
Nice to see you, indeed.
How do you feel to be back in an in-person event?
It's fantastic. It's especially after all that long time. I mean, seeing familiar faces, but also having a chance to meet new people and then seeing new people here, that's really what conferences is about. Not only the people you have been knowing from pre-COVID times, but also like seeing new faces, seeing what they're up to with Qt, how they want to use Qt. So already by now, the event is really awesome.
And so you're releasing Qt 6.4 beta this week. Is there anything from the roadmap or from 6.4 beta that you could give us a teaser on?
Yeah, I think the biggest topic in there is going to be the Qt for WebAssembly support. WebAssembly is a large and huge new platform coming to Qt because it enables you to bring Qt into the web. Having zero install solutions, being able to just get your Qt application running in the browser. But that's a major use case, and it's going to come and going to help so much also in hybrid scenarios where you have an HTML5 plus Qt together to really bring the best user experience out for your product or for your projects, for your applications, etc.
Yeah, that sounds awesome. That should be a big improvement. And is there a favorite part for you?
I've been a, let's say, backend or non-UI developer from my history. I'm mostly interested usually in the non-UI parts. So there's quite a lot of things coming also under the hood inside Qt Core, for instance, etc., and in the Qt networking side. So that's really where I'm really looking forward to.
Awesome. Excellent. Okay, thank you very much.
Thank you for having us.
Yeah. Hi, Anne. Thank you for speaking with us today.
Thank you for having me.
How does it feel to be back at an in-person event?
Very good. It feels so normal. It is good to see people and get in contact. So it's great.
Yes, it is.
I hope it stays like that.
Yeah, hopefully, fingers crossed.
Yeah.
How is Qt helping you fight cancer?
So for us, providing medical devices and also for research devices for research is very crucial to provide stable processes and stable software. So that is quite important for us, as well as usability. That the users don't make any stupid mistakes that could lead to a lost sample. So a lost sample meaning no patient treatment at that time point.
Of course. And during your talk, which was excellent, you mentioned the Prodigy device. Could you give us a bit more background on it?
Yes, sure. So the Prodigy is a quite long-lasting development, and I believe in other companies and the management would have lost trust, but our founder just kept on believing in that vision and also kept on going. Just the development was always continued, and now we are the world leading company that provides this sample to insight solution that you can basically, without any main user interaction, you can hang your bag in there and then you get at the end your cells back and can treat the patient. So that is the unique selling point for us and makes this a success for this instrument. And yeah, and based on the many clinical studies that are ongoing and are looking very promising, it is also making a great step towards this make cancer history.
And hopefully many more steps in the future.
Yes, that is our goal, of course.
Thanks. Hi, Dario. So thank you for being with us.
Hey, Robert. Thank you very much.
So what's it like for you to come back to an in-person event?
It is great and it is refreshing. I saw so many old friends from the community and, you know, it's just great to be back. It feels so good. So I'm super happy to be here.
Yeah, lots of people around. It's great.
with Seco, what are you using Qt for?
So Qt for us is one of the foundational blocks onto which our customers develop their own applications. So Seco does both embedded hardware and software as a platform, both in the cloud and at the edge. In the edge, we see massive adoption for Qt. And today, Qt, I believe, is still the framework of choice for those who develop HMIs and all these kind of applications. So Qt is used extensively. I will not say we use internally Qt, but we are providing a lot of Qt platforms to external users.
Excellent. And so other than this platform, is there anything else you're currently working on?
Yeah, I mean, we are currently working very hard on Clea, the platform offering from Seco Mind, the software branch of the group, and most of it is open source. So out of these open source projects, we are spinning out a set of different components we're releasing open on GitHub. And the next thing is an agent for device management written in Rust. A project I'm very excited about. It will not be bound only to Seco hardware. It will open completely to other different kind of hardware platforms. It's gonna have a container management, application management. Rust is such a cool technology to invest in this day. I'm super excited about it.
Awesome, yeah, that sounds great. Well, thank you for your time.
Thank you, Robert.
Since we last talked to Josef de Vargas from KDE about the world's first eco-certified software, the EcoLab was set up. He gave a lightning talk yesterday on why energy consumption of digitization matters and how to eco-certify your software. You can read all about the lab setup in the blog linked below. Next week, you'll find us at Embedded World in Nuremberg, where we will have our new Rust and Qt demo. It shows how to safely integrate a Rust backend into a QML UI. Come and see it at the Qt booth 258 in Hall 4. Thank you for watching. Stay safe. And feel free to share any questions and feedback below the video. See you next time.